Hello guys, Danny here. Today we got a video on some Black Ops 3. Today we're going to be talking about some skill-based matchmaker, or SBMM, as some people like to call it. But what that stands for is skill-based matchmaking. And in COD this has been a thing for quite a while now. It's kind of on and off with games. They sometimes put it in, they sometimes bring it out, they sometimes test things. And recently it just seems to be hitting hard on COD. So a lot of people have been complaining about this. I know that Drifter made a video on it. I'm sure many people have made a video on it. So I wanted to make a video on it with kind of some data to back the situation up. But so what I did was jump into a team deathmatch. This is a team deathmatch I did it in, got the actual stats in. But I did test it in about three other matches, and it did come up with pretty much the same results. One and two were a little bit off, but what I came up with in this match are pretty much in between. So I'd say this is the average that you get in this match, and I'll show you the results now. So on screen, as you can see, you have the lobby leaderboard on the left. That is the one in which we're all sat in the lobby, there's 12 of us. And you go on lobby leaderboard and it says how much, what your score per minute is. I'm there at the top with 324, and at the bottom we have someone called Don Longe. I don't know any of these people, I was playing solo at the time. We have a guy called Don Longe who's got 108. So what they pretty much do is give, say if these numbers are 1 through 12, so I'm 1 and Don Longe is 12. They actually split these up and they use the numbers, like a number kind of thing. And what I do is I will put on screen now, these are the teams that we got put in, and this is the in-game lobby screen as soon as I jumped into the game just after this lobby leaderboard. And what they did, they put me together with, so they put 1, 4, 7, 9, 10 and 12 together. And I make all them green on the lobby leaderboard now, as you can see. And then the other team consisted of 2, 3, 5, 6, 8 and 11. So what they do pretty much is put the best-ish with the worst-ish, and then they put the middle guys all together. Now really, this is such a wrong thing to do. It really shouldn't be like this, because a team of middle people are better, should be better than a team with a really good person, instead of like a few bad people. In this game, it kind of, this was the lobby that these numbers were from. So this game kind of shown, we were drawing pretty much the whole way through. I ended up getting, I don't know, like quite a few kills. I wouldn't say I carried team, but I was top and I did get probably the most kills. And we didn't win, but we did win by something like 5 kills. So in this particular game, it did work because, obviously just because I was doing quite well. I think there's another guy on my team doing quite well. But at the end, if we, you'll see that the leaderboard didn't shows that we actually had 3 people going minus, and I think we had a level 1 on our team, a level 6 on our team as well. And yeah, it was not easy to do. Now, obviously this is not an easy thing to sort out. It's not easy to put teams together because you got to try and match them up. It's just like, say you play football with your friends or something like that. You have like 12 people. It's very hard to pick perfectly even teams. It just always is. There's always one team that has that extra player that has a little bit more like talent or something. Just there always will be. It's just always, it's never, the only way to pick the same team is to just like play the exact player against the other player. That's the only way you can actually determine very even teams. So the teams are never going to be incredibly even on this game. Now how you can get around this is obviously jumping into a lobby with a party. That could be of like 3 of you, of 6 of you. 6 of you is probably the best. If you have 6 good players on team deathmatch, you absolutely destroy every time, no doubt. But the other way to get around this is just have a bad score per minute, and no one really wants to have a bad score per minute. I don't play team deathmatch very often, only have like 800 kills on it, something like that. But from this, I have this highest score per minute in the game because I've not played very much, that's pretty much why. But from this, I'm not sure what they can do about it. I mean, they can just try and like give the random teams out, just kind of like put 1 and 2 to get like 1 and then 3 and then 5. But it's never going to be perfect. They just can't do it perfectly. So I'm not really sure what they can really do about this. I just wanted to get this video out just to show the data. And as you can see, they are the teams that we got given, and they are the numbers that got set. So that is the kind of way they go round things. I also did a test earlier, which I won't put on screen now, but I will talk about, because you have to understand it kind of thing just from the numbers. But what they did was put one, I was the top one again, and 12 was the bottom one, obviously. They put me as number 1 and 2 on different teams. Then they split. Then they put 3 with 2 and 4 with me. And then from there, I got number 12, 11, 3 and 8. Now, very confusing teams. I had the best, the worst, and the second best and the second worst. So really evening these things out is going to be very difficult. I'm going to make this video just to show everyone how they work out, if you are wondering, and if you are getting absolutely crapped on by your team. I've seen various things on Reddit of people absolutely bossing something like Hardpoint or Nuketown on their own, and their team just don't do anything. And yeah, it's always been a problem in COD, but it just seems to have got a lot worse lately. Throughout this game, it's actually been alright, I thought, but I've been playing a lot of parties and recently started playing solo a bit more, so that might be a reason why. And yeah, that is pretty much it, guys. So if you have enjoyed this video, if you learned anything, if you fancy coming back, make sure you subscribe. Like the video if you did enjoy or learn anything. There's going to be some tip videos coming out soon. I'm going to get some Christmas new videos coming out. If you fancy looking at a big supply drop opening, I did upload one earlier. It was like just over 30 rare supply drops. I used the COD points to open them. I did get a few decent pulls in there, no melee weapons sadly. But I will put a link to that in my description. And also you can go back on my channel and just check that out now. But yeah guys, that's pretty much it for this video. And as you can see here, we're just about to win. And yeah, that... So yeah guys, if you have anything to say about this score per minute, or anything that you want to add and talk to me about, leave it in the comments, or get to just message me on Twitter or message me on YouTube. I always try and get back to you. Make sure you do that. And as you can see there on screen, I got 28 for 12 in the end. We had a few people go minus. We had a 6 for 11, a 5 for 12. But really that game was quite even. But most games aren't, to be honest. So yeah guys, that's pretty much it. And thanks for watching. Peace out for now.